Dear friends, welcome back. Today I am really excited because I have something special to show you. You know how much I like e-paper displays. I have found something amazing, an all-in-one 6-inch color e-paper board. It has everything we need. Let's see what it offers in detail. A few weeks ago, a company named Soldered, which I had never heard of before, got in touch with me to see if I was interested in any of their products. I receive messages from companies all the time, and most of the time, the products they offer are not interesting. This time was different. Soldered is a New York-based company. It is located in Croatia, and what got my attention was their philosophy and products. They are makers making products for makers. They love making stuff, just like we do. From all the products they offer, I really wanted to test out the 6-inch color e-paper display board. Now let me tell you why, from all the products they offer, I chose this board to test. I have been making things for over a decade now, and I am fascinated by e-ink technology and its uses. If you are not familiar with it, an e-ink display uses electricity only when it updates its contents. So, even though this device is now off, it still displays this image. I have built many projects in this channel using an e-ink display. I always wanted an all-in-one board, a board that will contain everything I will ever need to build a project and that it will be easy to work with. So, let's see what this board offers. First of all, this board uses a big color e-ink display. It is the first time I use a color e-ink display and I love it. Color adds so much to any project. This display can display 7 different colors: white, black, red, yellow, blue, green, and orange. It offers a resolution of 600 by 448 pixels and the refresh rate of the screen is about 11 seconds. Since the display uses the e-paper technology, it only consumes power when it refreshes its contents. So, if we don't update the display all the time, we have almost zero power consumption. This board can achieve a deep sleep current of 18 microamps. I like it. We can build projects that can last on battery for months. Amazing stuff. The board also features an ESP32 microcontroller with integrated Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity. We can also find an SD card slot where we can store files and images to display on the screen. The board can be programmed and powered by a USB Type-C connector, and it features a battery charger and a LiPo battery. Also, the board comes with a real-time clock module to keep track of time and reduce power consumption. As you can see, the board also gives us many GPIO pins to connect our sensors and devices. The board also comes with a 3D printed enclosure, and the files are also available online if you want to modify them. What else could a maker ask for? Everything we want from hardware is here. Now, let's see what happens with the software of the board. We can use this board with Arduino and MicroPython. I chose to use it with Arduino because I am more familiar with it. It took me less than 5 minutes to write my first program on this board, following the step-by-step instructions the company offers. I remember when I had to use a similar board from a Chinese vendor, I had to struggle for hours to find the proper instructions on how to use the board. If you value your time and your sanity, this board will save you a lot of searching and trial and error to see what works and what not. To use this board, we first have to add an additional board definition file to the Arduino IDE. This will download all the necessary files needed for the Arduino IDE to recognize the board when plugged in. The next step is to download the Inkplate library. In the library manager, just search for Inkplate and install the library. That's it. Our board is ready. We can plug it in, select the correct board and USB port, and we are ready to program it. That was easy, wasn't it? Now let's load a sample project to see how the colors are looking and how fast the display is updating. The library we just installed comes with dozens of examples that will decrease the time needed to develop your own projects drastically. All the basic functionality you need is already developed, like connecting to the Wi-Fi, downloading images from the web, reading from the SD card, and so on. You can use the examples directly from the Arduino IDE, but I recommend downloading the GitHub repository because the projects are updated constantly. The first example I'm going to load is a sketch that displays all the colors of the display on the screen. Now that the sketch is loaded, we can upload it to the board. The display starts updating. I don't know if you can notice, but the syntax of the code that draws on the screen looks very familiar. It is very familiar because the library we have to use to draw the display is 100% compatible with the Adafruit GFX library we have all used in the past. Amazing! The designers of the board had thought about everything. They did everything they could to make our lives as makers as easy as possible. Details like this matter a lot. All the colors the screen can display are now visible one next to the other. That's the colors we can work with. Remember, this is not a traditional display. We cannot combine these colors to create other colors. Each pixel on this display can only have one of the seven colors. While the display can only show seven colors directly, we can use a technique called dithering to create the illusion of more colors. Dithering works by adding a small amount of noise to the image, which helps to blend the colors together and create smoother transitions. This is best understood with an example. I have loaded a demo project which downloads an image from the web and then displays it on the display. First, let's load a random image without dithering. I sped up the video in order not to waste your time. As you can see, the image appeared using the seven colors of the display. Now, let's load another random image with dithering enabled. I just set this argument to true. As you can see, the image that is now loaded appears more realistic. It gives the illusion of more colors, even though we just use the same seven colors. Great! We can do many things with just seven colors. One of the most interesting examples I found in the examples that come with the board is the cryptocurrency tracker. As you can see, we can build very impressive and practical projects with a board like this. This project retrieves current data about Bitcoin from the web and displays it on the screen, along with a diagram. How cool is that? I'm not a big fan of cryptocurrencies, but I can see the potential of this project. We can use any available API on the internet and have a great way to visualize the data we are interested in. It is very cool! The last project I want to share with you is this simple web server project. The device can act as a web server and we can type something on this HTML web form and it will update the display. Amazing stuff! We can build a very cool and practical to-do list with this device. Do I recommend this device? Absolutely! It is by far the easiest e-paper display I have ever used and it works reliably. I can't ask for anything more. The level of detail put in designing the board makes me happy. We now have a great EU-based company that builds great boards. I plan to use this device to build the e-paper weather station I always wanted, a color weather station project that can last on batteries for months, that will also get weather forecast from the internet. Stay tuned, it is going to be cool. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.